Hello everyone, welcome to Mentorspool. My name is Ankit. Today in this video, I'll be covering BTP Identity Provisioning Service. We also call it as SAP IPS. Okay, and this is the very, very important service as a part of BTP security. So just let's understand, what actually does. Okay, so normally we divide the use cases of IPS in two segments. One is source and target framework. One is IPS proxy system framework. Before understanding that, I would just give you a one-liner introduction to this. IPS is a service which reads identity data from one system and writes into, or we can say provision into, a target system. Okay. Actually, the work is provisioning the identities. What do you mean by identities? Identity can have user details, right? It can have user ID, first name, last name, or many other attribute along with what all the roles has been assigned to that user, right? If you want to provision into a target system from any of the source system, you can use IPS in between. So this is the first use case where we say IPS is used in source and target framework as it reads identity data from one system and then provision into different system. If I try correlating with your on-premise system, if you're aware of SAP IDM or if you know SAP IDM, IPS is quite similar to SAP IDM, or I would say in cloud, it is IPS is corresponding to SAP IDM, right? So if I take example, you want to provision the user data from SuccessFactors to S4HANA, right? Why you want to do that? There definitely could be a scenario, right? Because there could be the case your employees who are joining new, their account is greater, they are getting maintained in a SuccessFactors, right? But definitely their users to be created in S4HANA also, right? Then definitely that in that case, you want to provision the user which is created in S4HANA to, sorry, SuccessFactors, and you want to provision those users to S4HANA, so you can use IPS in between, and you can schedule a periodic job where every time or with that interval, there will be a provisioning job will run, which will read the all updated data and it will provision into S4HANA. There also could be a case where maybe you are using Azure ADFS as an identity provider in your landscape, right? But SAP recommends IAS as identity provider, at least for all SAP cloud systems, right? So you may want to provision some of the identities from Azure ADFS to IAS, right? In that case, you can always use source and target framework of IPS, read all the required identities or user data, or maybe if you have segregated them at a part of groups, maybe those groups only, right? And you can read and write into IAS, and that's how you would be able to achieve this in source and target framework, right? And there's one more use case we have in IPS, one more scenario I would say we have in IPS, IPS as a proxy system. Why we are saying proxy, let's try understanding here also. The IPS job only is to reading identity data from a system and writing into target system. Okay. Why we see proxy here is normally the job of provisioning is raised in IPS only when we talk about source and target framework. IPS is the one which leads, which triggers the read job, and then it completes with the write job or provision job, right? It's all triggered in IPS, but there could be some scenario where we have any access management tool, right? Maybe IAG or SAP IDM, and SAP IAG or SAP IDM may be triggering the provisioning request, okay, to any target system. Their trigger is actually happening, provisioning request trigger is actually happening in that system, maybe IAG or IDM. IPS job only is to go ahead and provision that. But in our previous case, IPS itself was triggering the provisioning request, and it was reading and also it was writing, right? So here, when I say these IAG or SAP IDM, any other access management tool, access governance tool, if take the lead of triggering the provisioning request, in that case, we say IPS is a proxy system. Let's try understanding this complete diagram a bit better. Okay. You know, IAG is access governance tool. What access governance tool does is, we have a separate video in AI for IAG. Guys, you can go and have a look. Okay. If I just quickly show you, we have access IAG video I have uploaded in the channel. You can go and refer it, understand it a bit better. But let's take example here. IAG is a tool which will do risk analysis for any of these systems. Okay. Access risk analysis for any of these systems. So what it needs, first, it needs all the user data to be synced in IAG. So when it needs all the user data to be synced in IAG, then IPS will help to read here and write here. Okay. Once the access analysis is done, definitely some mitigation or some any some actions will be taken as a result of risk analysis. So once those actions has been taken, then definitely the identity data, which is actually synced from here, has been updated. Now it again need to provision to the target system, right? Correct. Maybe in SCC, right? So what happens once read transformation happens, while, you know, first it do repository sync, after the you know, access governance job is completed by IAG, it will provision, then the write transformation will happen. So guys, if you want to learn this in detail, definitely you have to reach out to us, and we do provide very extensive training on this in both the scenarios, and you can come and learn. We'll show everything in detail. Okay, just to maybe give you a bit idea, I can definitely open and show you things here. So this is my IPS system. Okay, just to give you some hands-on experience, okay, or how we understand this. So first of all, let me tell you, this IPS is a part of Cloud Identity Services. Okay, so Cloud Identity Services has two capabilities, SAP IAS and SAP IPS. Okay. And if you see here, identity provisioning is this tab we have, in which we can do some of the tasks, right? Also, we have other tabs, but that those are more related to identity authentication service, which is the other part of Cloud Identity Services, right? Here you see source system, right? You can add source systems from where you want to read the data. You can add target systems where you want to write the data, right? And again, you can add proxy systems in case of any other system which is leading the provisioning, you know, request, right? So that's where we can go. We can do integrate systems. We can define all the transformation. We can define the properties and all those things in very detail. We already have a lot of integrations done here with different scenarios we have done while we are teaching, right? Let's say like we are reading data from Microsoft Azure AD, and then we are maybe writing into SAP IPS. So see, mentorspool IAS is there, and we are reading data from Azure AD from source and writing into mentorspool IAS, which is the target, right? So this is what we'll learn here in detail, and I hope it gives you a bit idea what IPS does. Please reach out to us if you're looking for training on this. And guys, we have lot many other, you know, videos uploaded for all these services, like SAP BTP Audit Log Management Service, BTP Alert Notification Service, BTP Transport Management Service, BTP Continuous Integration Continuous Delivery, BTP Application Logging Service, BTP DevOps, BTP Application Autoscaler Service, BTP Identity Provisioning Service, which we covered today, SAP BTP Identity Authentication Service, Cloud Identity Services, SAP Identity Access Governance, and then BTP Connectivity Service, BTP Destination Service, BTP Build Work Zone, or many more, right? So if you want to learn about these, please go ahead and watch other videos we have available on the channel. Please go and subscribe and like it, and hit on the bell icon so that you get update, because we are going to add more videos for more other services we have on BTP. Thank you so much for watching.